Hello, I'm Graham Horton and welcome to this product review for a brand new magnetic filter system for your DSLR or mirrorless cameras from a company called Velium. Now, these magnetic filter systems aren't new, they've been around for a few years now and I've been using them since they first came out. But what's new about this new innovation from Velium is the fact that you can control the amount of attenuation of light with the back circular polarizing filter if you're using the variable ND kit. So this is a typical magnetic mount filter system. You've got the thread that screws onto the front of your camera lens and we've got the variable ND effect from the front element here. But what you haven't got is the ability to control the amount of polarization cut by the rear element of this lens when it's screwed onto your camera. So if you're shooting a landscape, for example, the way that you've installed it onto your camera, you may see that you've got a cut or you may not. Now the advantage of this new system from Velium, the MagRota system, is that the rear element is rotatable. So you can see the effect on screen now. I can actually eliminate the sheen from the leaves in this particular video by just rotating that back element. So that is the design element which is different to all the other magnetic mount systems and one that I can really recommend that you try. Now that's the real benefit of this system. If you're just using ordinary fixed ND filters, you won't see any benefit of the system. But if you do switch to variable ND filters, or you've got filters where you need to rotate the components such as streak filters, then you will need this device. It does give you the desired effect. Well, first of all, a quick refresh on how these filters work. If you take two ordinary circular polarizing filters and mount them actually together with the opposing faces together, you can see that as I rotate this filter, you can achieve a change in the density, and that is the way we achieve a variable ND. So by rotating two circular polarizing filters against each other, you'll have this variable ND effect. But the problem is you can over rotate them and you end up with a X shape, which is the crossover of the both polarized planes. So they show up on your image. So a lot of these filter systems have stops, physical hard stops, which prevent you going beyond that polarization problem. That's implemented in the MagRota system from Velium, but it has two new unique features, and I'll show you that when we get to the stage where we're looking at the variable ND component. So this is the MagRota base system, and it's contained in its own little carry pouch. This particular one is the 82mm filter size, but you can also get them in 86, 95 and the Z mount 1424S type mount, so it covers a whole range of lenses. Additionally, you'll get some step-up rings with each of the mounts, so you can go, in this particular case, 67, 72, 77, up to the 82mm of this thread, and you'll get equivalent rings with the other cameras. So this particular ring is 82. My lens here is the Canon 24 to 105mm lens. Canon full-frame camera, so the 24mm is the actual focal length at that minimum focal length. So I need to adapt from the 77mm to the 82 using the supplied step-up ring. So just screw that onto the rear threads of the unit. So once we've installed the step-up ring for the respective lens, we can install that onto the camera lens. So the whole system is now ready to install your selected filter. So you can see on this device we've got the locking ring, which allows us to rotate the component, which will rotate the rear element of the filter set if you need to. If we look at the system closely, you'll see we've got this retaining component which has got 8 slots which marry up with 8 lands on the filters to drive the rear element should you need to. It's finely machined, it's really smooth, the lens step-up rings are smooth as well. The whole system cries out perfection in engineering. And in fact, at the end of this video, I'll show you some minutes of a video produced by Velium to show you how these are manufactured. It's a totally fascinating watch from the design process through the machining, anodizing, and then final assembly. So I'll put that right at the very end of this video for you to watch for your own interest. I was fascinated by that video. Let's now look how you can install a filter into this system, and the filters are available in different packs. We have a basic pack which will be the dual CPL, which is always going to be the back component of your VND system, and the 2-5 stop. So that would be a pack of two filters. But don't forget, you're getting the dual CPL and the 2-5 stop. But that 2-5 stop is also a polarized filtering as well. So if you don't install the CPL, you can just use the polarizing filter of this element to give you another one stop ND filter as well. So you've got three filters there for the price of two. If you went for the next pack size, which is the basic kit, you'll have the dual CPL, the 2-5 stop, and the 5-9 stop. When we talk about the dual CPL, I'll explain what that dual CPL really means. Now, there's also another set, the long exposure set, which contains the IRND 3 stop, the 6 stop, and the 10 stop. So all these filters are infrared coated. So that means that even with the high sensitivity sensors, which may have more of a susceptibility to infrared, the infrared coating on these filters will eliminate that, and you'll get color fidelity as you'd expect from a high quality filter. They also do a landscape kit, which is again the dual CPL plus a graduated 3-stop ND filter, which has got a 3-stop graduation at the top, clear at the bottom, and also it contains the 10-stop infrared filter as well. Then they do the director's kit and filmmaking kit, which has got the streak and the blackness filter. So if you look at the screen now, you see the whole range of filters that are available for this particular kit. So let's have a look how we would install a filter on the system. And we'll first of all take just a fixed ND filter. So this will be the 3-stop. So again, each of the filters is contained in its own little pouch. So each of the filters is clearly marked with the label on the pouch. So you can see this is going to be the IRND 3-stop filter. Now, each of the filters will come with its warranty card. So you've got 12 months warranty for each filter, and also quite a large size microfiber cleaning cloth should you need to clean that filter. But more about cleaning later in the video. So here's the actual filter. You can see that it's got printed legends on there. This says IRND 3-stop, so that's an 8x attenuation. Each filter has a hierarchy in its filter set series. So this one is photo 3. And you always place the lowest number towards the lens. So if you've got photo 1, photo 2, and photo 3, photo 1 would be the nearest to the lens, then the photo 2 filter, and then the photo 3. On the other side, you'll see it's marked up in a Cine equivalence. So this is Cine 4. So again, there are four series filters. So you'd have Cine 1 nearest to the lens, Cine 2, Cine 3, and then Cine 4. So that's the way that the filter set work to give you maximum efficiency. So on this filter, you might just be able to see there, we have got 8 of these drive pegs or drive areas. They locate to the slots that I showed you in the MagRota base. So just place it this way around and then just rotate it until you hear that drop into position and it's latched in onto the magnets. If you needed to, you could actually rotate that rear element, and that rear element is the patented design of this particular device. Gives you that ability to rotate the rear element of a circular polarizing filter set if you need to. But obviously with a fixed density ND filter, you don't need to rotate it. So I'll just leave that in the locked position. Now, because of the thinness of these filters, you can actually mount 3 of them on a 14mm lens, or 4 of them on a 16mm lens. It's got enough field of view to allow you to do that. If you wanted to mount a second filter, let's make this into a 9-stop by adding the 6-stop. So again, removing it from its pouch. You can see this is marked up IRND 6-stop, so that's a 64x attenuation. Marked up as photo 3 or Cine 4 again. So this one can mount directly onto that mount, but you put the lens again towards the lens, so that will go over like so, and because of those lens and the tracks, it will center itself magnetically coupled, so this isn't going to come off. And now you've got a 9-stop filter. If you wanted to add another filter and make this into a 19-stop filter, you could add another fixed ND filter. So again, looking at this, you can see it says IR&D 10 stop. That's 1,000 times attenuation. Photo 3, Cine 4. So again, we could install this onto this filter set. So in total now, we've got a 19 stop filter, and you see they all stack concentrically because of the magnetic fixtures. To remove the filters, you just need to put your finger between each of the elements and then just remove them one by one, and then the final element would remove like that. Now, I mentioned in the landscape kit you get the graduated ND filter, and this is a three-stop graduated ND, so you can see the top portion of the filter is three stops and then it's fade down to zero and the bottom is clear. Now, I'm not sure that this is a perfect solution for landscape photographers. Normally we would use a graduated filter in a 4-inch square mount, which allows you to position that graduation exactly where you want for your composition. So if you've got more sky and less ground, you can actually move this further down, or if you've got more ground and less sky, you can move this up. Obviously with a fixed portion halfway down the frame, you're not going to be able to set your composition, but if you're shooting video, then this will darken down the sky. But what I wanted to show you was the actual filter coatings on these lenses. On screen now you can see a graphic which shows all the layers. They're actually ultra low reflection and they're only 3% reflectivity. The graphic shows 6%, but Valium have updated that and said no, it's only a 3% reflection. So 97% of the light passes through the lens, so you're going to get minimal ghosts and flares. Even if you shine a bright light directly into the filter, you can see on screen there's very little ghosting and flaring from these filters. But what I wanted to show you was the fact that if you look at the filter coating, they've got the scratch proof coating and they've got the oil proof coating. Now I've got quite greasy fingers, and what I'm going to do is put my fingers on the filter surface. So I'm going to grip the filter and squeeze it quite hard, and then we'll look to see if we can see a fingerprint on that lens. And I'm going to do it by reflected light. There may be just a slight indication round about there that there's a filter. Let's have a look on the other side. Hardly anything to worry about. Now, what I'm going to do is to accentuate that by using a marker pen. And I'm actually going to write on the filter surface. So you can see that has gone onto the filter surface, but if you look closely, it's beaded rather than anything else. So that oil coating has stopped it from penetrating. What I'm going to do now is use the supplied microfiber cloth, and I'm just going to try to remove that as you would normally do with your filter set, circular motions. The other side to remove that fingerprint if there was one. And now you can see that filter is perfectly clear, and if we're trying to pick up some reflected light, it's perfectly clear. So the coatings on these filters are superb. Because this is a graduated ND filter, we need to ensure that the cutoff point is always horizontal. So when we place that in our base system and lock it in position on the magnet rotor, we can actually rotate it with the rear element so we can make sure that it's horizontal and giving us the correct cut to our landscape horizon. Now, when we buy our filters, we're probably looking for three key points. One is the fact that it will not affect the lens resolution, so we don't lose any sharpness due to any optical deficiency in these filters. We probably want them to be color perfect, so color fidelity is going to be a key point. And the third will be that the variable ND stops are accurate, so we can actually use them for photography to make sure we can get the correct attenuation. In terms of optical sharpness, I've done several tests with all these filter sets, and on screen now you can see a shot taken with no filter and then one taken with the 5-9 stop plus the circular polarizer and at 9 stop. So you can see there's no difference in sharpness of that scene between no filter and the one with a dual pack filter. In terms of colour fidelity, again I've done some studio tests using a fixed temperature LED light source, then taking the shot without filter and then installing the filter, not changing the white balance or any white balance shift is due to the filter itself. And you can see on all the ranges of filters there's a very, very minimal shift. I think the maximum I saw was 9 points in blue using the Photoshop color picker tool. So again, in optical quality, they're superb. The shot glass filter base is perfectly optically flat and you don't get any distortions, no loss of sharpness and no loss of color quality. If we now look at the variable ND filter, of course we need to use two circular polarizing filters. The first one will be the rear element, which is marked photo 1 or cine 2. And if you notice on here, we've got two bands. We've got the one marked W and the other is marked T. That is to allow two physical hard stops of the filter to prevent the X shape appearing if you go too far with the rotation. Now we know the X pattern occurs much earlier in the rotation of the two filters with a wide angle lens than it does with the telephoto end. So that's why we only use a smaller portion of the filter in the wide section and a much wider area on lenses from 35mm and above. A look at the filter again, it says cine 2 in the hierarchy of the cine filters and photo 1 in the photo set. And again, you've got the dry pins on the rear of the filter and they align with the 8 slots in the MagRota base. So the first element will go in with the dry pins towards the lens, and again just rotate that until you hear it drop in place like so. That means that it's flat and optically flat to your lens. The second element will be either your 2-5 or your 5-9 stop. So this is the 2-5 marked up, VND 2-5 and polarizer, so it is a polarized filter marked up as photo 1 plus, so 1 plus will only sit on top of a number 1. Turn that over, you can see that it's marked cine 3. So in the hierarchy, cine 2 is the back one, cine 3 would be the next one. And the tracks on these filters, which give you the concentricity, are sort of coated with a material which allows them to slip and slide very easily. Now if I was using this lens at its widest focal length, 24mm, I'd install the VND this way around so that it's on the wide end, and there's a drive pin which allows you to rotate the filter quite easily, so that just sits on there magnetically and you'll find that it has got two hard stops, so the minimum position and the maximum position are clearly defined. For video shooters, then obviously you're going to set your shutter speed equal to twice the frame rate, so you just be observing your camera and moving the variable ND until you've got your shutter speed equal to twice the frame rate. For stills photographers, we normally use fixed stops, as you normally have say on this particular filter, where you can see we've got the 2-5 stops clearly marked. Now at the moment with this particular set, there are no calibration points on the system, but they are going to adopt a system where you will be given calibration marks for the photo set of filter, so you'll be able to see the 2, 4, 8, 16, 32 attenuation marks on the filters when they come from production. So again, you've got the fixed stops for your maximum position and your minimum position. If I wanted to use the lens at say 50mm, then I could swap this over to the telephoto side, and again you've got a minimum and a maximum cut. But the beauty of these filter sets is that they are 2-5 or 5-9, but because of the extended track you get an extra 3 stops. When you get the calibration marks for the photo filters, you'll see we've got all the way from ND2 all the way up to ND4000, so you can see we've got the amount of attenuation needed for long exposure photos. With the stills photographer, obviously some cameras cannot expose through that density, so we would normally set our focus and set our exposure and then calculate by using an aperture chart or an app on our phone what the new value would be for the shutter speed when you apply a certain amount of filtration. So that's where the calibrated stops will be of benefit for the photo shooters, to give you an indication of how much attenuation you're going to be putting in. So now we have the VND filter set compiled. We've got our dual CPL at the back. We've got our 2-5 stop set to give us the correct attenuation, i.e. twice the frame rate for our shutter speed or the right attenuation for our stills photo. We can then use the fact that this has a rotating back so we can get the right amount of polarization for cutting out any reflections on water, leaves or sky. We can use that to maximum effect because we've got that rotating base, which is the patented feature of this design. So that gives us that wonderful effect where we can actually remove reflections from water, tree leaves, etc. Once you've got that point where you need it to be, just lock it by moving that lever to the lock position, and now everything is locked in place. And don't forget, because this is a dual filter system, each of these is a polarizing filter in its own right. So if we looked at this filter, it would be the same as the dual CPL. If we remove the pin and it just screws into a little hole on the side of the filter, don't worry if you lose the pin, there's a spare one supplied with each filter set. You can then install this into the MagRota base and it becomes its own circular polarizing filter, which you can rotate with a rear element as you would with the dual CPL. If you're using the 5-9 stop, if you've got the standard kit, then again this will have a 32 times attenuation. Again, you could remove this pin and you could install this onto this filter set, and if you notice there's a small notch, so this filter will fit over that filter, and now you've got a 32 ND filter plus the one stop of the back filter, so you've got a multiple. With the VND 5-9 stop, you've also got included here the ND32, so you could use this on its own right as a ND32 filter with its own inbuilt polarizing lens, or you could combine it with the 2-5 stop, which is effectively a one stop ND, so you can apply both of these filters, and there's a peg on here and a notch on this particular filter. You can put the two together like so, and now you've got a combined filter set to give you extra attenuation should you need it. So there we are, that is the new magnetic mount system from Valium. I've been testing this now for about a month and I've had no problems with it whatsoever. No fingerprints, no scratches. It has been a wonderful kit to work with, and the optical quality of the filters is absolutely superb. So I've got no concerns about recommending these filters to anyone in any serious professional or amateur environment. So now I'll include the production video that is produced by Valium, show you how these are made, and I think you'll find it an interesting shoot. Don't forget to have a look at the landing page for the Valium filters and the Kickstarter launch, and I'll put a link to that in the video description below. So until my next video, thanks for watching, please do take care, and I hope to see you all very, very soon. Goodbye for now.